Hello. Currently. Alright, yeah, we are on the air. Okay. Gonna start a new game, and this will be gameplay one of The Cruel King and the Great Hero. There will be heavy text reading in the beginning because it's gonna be tutorial, and yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know to expect that for the 30 minutes for part one.
これはここではないどこか、今ではないいつかの物語。石造りの城壁に囲まれた町で人々が暮らし、森や山には魔物たちが住んでいる。そんな少し不思議な世界でのお話です。人間たちの国から少し離れた山の上に、王様ドラゴンが治める小さな魔物の国がありました。魔物ばかりが住んでいるはずのその国には、なぜか一人だけ人間の女の子が暮らしていました。女の子の名前はユウ。ユウはある理由から立派な勇者になることに憧れていて、毎日修行をしています。王様ドラゴンはユウの育ての親です。赤ん坊の頃に両親と死に別れたユウを引き取って育ててきました。王様ドラゴンの願いはユウを立派に育て上げること。だからユウが憧れる立派な勇者になれるように、一緒にユウの修行のお手伝いをしています。ユウ、今日は山のふもとまで一人で冒険をしてみようか。
一人でいいの？
ユウは目を輝かせます。うん、ただしふもとまでだよ。そして教えたことをきちんと守るんだ。
わかった、行ってくるね。
そう言うと王様ドラゴンがあっという暇もなく、ユウはもうふもとへ向かって駆け出していってしまいました。やれやれ、元気なのはいいことだけど、もう少し落ち着きが欲しいところだな。そんなことを考えながら、王様ドラゴンはユウの姿が小さくなっていくのを見届けます。さてと、ユウの姿が見えなくなったのを確認した王様ドラゴンは、近くの林の中へがさりごそりと姿を隠します。一人で冒険させるのは心配だ。こっそり見守ってあげなければ、などと独り言を言いながら、こそこそとユウの後を追いかけ始めたのでした。
Alright, if I just keep following this path, I'll reach the foot of the mountain. There are also mean monsters along the way, so I better be careful. Alright, I'm gonna move along. This is just showing for the stamina, enemy damage.Keep a close eye on everything so I don't pass out. Only thing that I have available is attack. Everything else looks like it's grayed out. I do like how, compared between this game and the Liar Princess and the Blind Prince, how they change for kind of, well, the battling itself. Like, with the Liar Princess and the Blind Prince, it was more sort of like platforming, still puzzle solving and stuff as well. But I do really like how they incorporated this combat style for this game. And just like the other game that they created, visually speaking, just really great with the scenery, background, the character design. I will always love the little squeaks when defeating my enemies. Oh my gosh, Yu is so adorable. I think it's also cute too, she has like this one little like fang tooth that's just peeking out from her mouth. It's just adorable. Alright, yep. Pressing that for the main menu. It's wanting me to only select items. Power fruit. Increase my HP if I eat it. Okay. We're gonna keep on going. You can see the Papa Dragon just following along. Okay, so now guard, and then the running legs to the left of that looks like it's gonna be the escape option. Select another action. Going over again. Also use items during battle. Let's see, anything else? It's having me wanting to read through stuff, but I know you guys can see what's popping up for the tutorial, so it's just one enemy. We're just gonna smack him. He has 3 hearts. And he's probably gonna go down on this next attack, if not. Okay, cool, yeah. This time we got a treasure chest. 2 shells for experience. Level up. Alright, yep, defeating monsters gets you XP. Got it, got it. You levels up, she will receive stat points. Mm-hmm. I'll faint if stamina runs out. Energy consumes when skills are used. Stay tuned to learn about skills. Got it, got it. How much attack or damage you deals for attack. Use taken damage defense. Speed, you can, how fast you can act. Okay. If they seem too strong, might need to level up more. If I'm too, okay. Alrighty. Confetti. Yep, I've gotten the hang of it. Okay. Hit the plus. Hit the quick save. And then the regular save and load options. For quick save, more than likely you'll be able to on the main menu hit continue, but then if you hit just the regular save, you can be able to load that save file. The difference between those two. Okay, the same one enemy variety. I just find it adorable that the main protagonist, she has for her little helmet the little cooking pot, and my weapon of choice is a twig. I got a power fruit in case my hearts go down. Fantastic. And then also getting some more goodies here, a power ring. and now we're gonna equip it. Got it. Mm-hmm. Select character. And we're gonna end up going down to one of the two accessory slots. Equip power ring. Alrighty. Over here to the left. I'm not gonna like these. I'm sticking to my, to what I think these creatures kind of look like. A cross between a frog because of like the little eyes. I don't know why it reminds me, yeah, of a pineapple. And a Lickitung. I might end up getting a little bit annoying whenever there's more than one of them that ends up using the attack of Basque in order to heal themselves repeatedly. That's okay. We'll just end up getting stronger and then we'll just hit them eventually with one attack. I got this time 3 for the power fruits. I just realized on this big tent right here where it has like the target symbol, it has like a little stick sticking out where there's 3 carrots just dangling there. Out of the 2 enemies, this one's I don't really care for, but I like the music in the background. Alrighty. Fork in the road, check the map, got it. And we're gonna be heading south. And after that, gonna head west, okay. Mm-hmm. Exclamation mark, where to go, got it. Okay. Okay, and then we're gonna just kind of see. It's a pretty decent size map area. And we have a sea creature over here. Looks like over here we have kind of like a little bit of like a wasteland, mountain regions, volcano, snowy region. Cool. Just one of them. I am kind of curious to know, like, what, since we don't have it available yet, like, what skills you will get later on, and how many skills she can have in one given time. I'm thinking, of course, eventually over time, too, the twig will be upgraded to something else. Like an ultimate weapon. Okay. We got some boulders in the middle of the road that are blocking our path. Yu's like, I can't go forward. What should I do? If I hit it with all my might, maybe it'll break apart. This time I paid attention to what was going more so around me. That was cool. That Papa Dragon over there did help you. Oh no, I have 9 hearts. We're getting a power fruit. I should have done this before getting into battle, so then I wouldn't have to use that on one of my turns. I'm trying to remember what that means for them. The best thing I can hope for whenever there's 2 or more of the exact same of these Lickitung creatures is that they don't hopefully use Bask repeatedly to heal for health. To attack instead of trying to heal itself. Okay, that won't be gone. And I got 1 left. Vanquish my foes.
お父さん。 王様ドラゴンを見つけたユウは 嬉しそうに駆け寄ります。 どう？ ここまで一人で来られたんだよ。すごい？ああ、よくやったな、ユウ。すごいぞ。ユウは得意になって、へへへ、と満面の笑みを作ります。さあ、住処に帰ろうか。ユウ、背中に乗りなさい。 ユウは王様ドラゴンの背中に飛び乗ります。ほら、優しく乗りなさい。ごめんなさい。ユウはニコニコと悪びれない様子です。 王様ドラゴンは大きな翼を羽ばたかせ、力強く空へ飛び立ちます。 私、お父さんと空を飛ぶの好きなんだ。お父さんもユウを背中に乗せて飛ぶのが大好きだよ。そしてあっという間に山の隅かにたどり着いたのでした。
At day's end, go to bed. Welcome back, Miss Yu. Did your training go well today? Welcome back, Yu. The world is full of treasure. Let's go on an adventure tomorrow, too. I really like the, I didn't notice it till now actually. Like, I like the little sparkles where it looks like the light's reflecting off of some of the stones on the floor and it's creating like these little sparkle effects to happen on them. That's kind of a nice touch. You know, it's the little things. And I really do love the art style. What's up? How's your training going? Did you get even stronger? Oh, welcome back. Don't cause too much trouble for His Majesty now. Yeah, I guess I can't really go up there. I really like this shiny little levitating crystal right here. It doesn't seem to serve a purpose, but it's cool. Alright, we're gonna see. Yeah. I clicked stay up by accident. Good night.
一日の終わり。ユウと王様ドラゴンは、住処の奥の寝床で。一緒に寝ます。ユウは王様ドラゴンの大きな体にもたれかかって、お休みの準備は万端です。王様ドラゴンは尻尾と腕でユウを優しく包み込みます。ねえお父さん、なんだい？寝る前にパパのお話聞かせて。ユウは毎晩寝る前のお話を王様ドラゴンにおねだりします。わかったわかった。どこからにしようかと王様ドラゴンが考え始めると、最初からとユウがリクエスト。よし、そうしようか。少しの間を置いて王様ドラゴンは静かに語り始めました。ユウのパパはね、とても立派な勇者だったんだよ。その昔、世界は恐ろしい力を持つ魔王によって支配されようとしていた。魔王はたくさんの魔物を従え、人間たちの国に攻め込んできた。人間たちも抵抗したが、魔物には勝てなかった。人間たちはみんなもうダメだと思った。希望はない、滅びるしかないと。そんな時、ある町で一人の青年が立ち上がった。さて、今日はここまでにしよう。そろそろ寝なさい、ユウ。王様ドラゴンが視線を落とすと、ユウはもう今にも眠りそうなくらいうとうととまどろんでいました。お父さん、私ね、私お父さんも好きだけど、パパのことも大好き。それでね、私パパみたいな立派な勇者になるんだ。 眠ったか。おやすみ。勇者よ、 お前の娘は元気に育っているぞ。父親のような立派な勇者に憧れる優は、今日も早起きして朝の修行を始めます。朝の日課は剣の素振りです。剣と言いましたが、実際のところ優が持っているのはただの木の棒でも、この木の棒はいつかの修行の時に見つけた大のお気に入りなのです。ずっと使い続けているので、優の手にすっかり馴染んでいます。今日もやるぞ。優は昨日の冒険が楽しかったのでとってもご機嫌です。いつもより大張り切りでブンブンと木の棒を振り回していたのですが、ユウは近くにあった岩に気づかず、棒を思いっきりぶつけてしまいました。
Poor you.
木でできたその棒はバキンという大きな音を立てて、見るも無残に折れてしまいました。玉座の間に駆け込み、棒が折れたとおいおい泣くユウを、王様ドラゴンはよしよしと慰めます。そうだ、こうしよう。今日の修行は麓の村の鍛冶屋さんまでお買い物に行くというのはどうだい？
Yes, we're gonna go. Yeah, to the blacksmith.
きっと優にぴったりの新しい剣が見つかるよ。王様ドラゴンは優に提案します。村の鍛冶屋さんまで今日も一人で行っていい？えぐえぐと泣きながら優は聞き返します。うんうん、今日も一人で行っていいよ。行けるかな？うん、わかった。行ってくるね。ユウはまだ棒が折れたことを引きずっていましたが、一人での冒険やまだ見ぬ剣へのワクワクの方が勝っている様子。よろよろしながらも玉座の間を出ていきました。やれやれ。ケラはいるか？王様ドラゴンが呼びかけると、玉座の間の天井から小柄な雲のような魔物が白く細い糸にぶら下がり、スルスルと降りてきました。はい、うん、王様と呼んでくれないか？失礼しました。何かご用でしょうか、王様？すまんが、優より先回りして鍛冶屋へ向かってほしい。王様ドラゴンは優のために扱いやすい武器を渡してもらえるよう、鍛冶屋の主人にお願いしておいてほしいとケラに頼みました。承知しました。では行ってまいります。そう言うとケラはスススーッと音もなく糸を登り、姿を消しました。これでよし。いや、念のためにユウの後を追うか。こっそりと。そう言って王様ドラゴンはのっそりと玉座から立ち上がりました。
Alrighty. Actually, I think we're going to save here for the day. And then next time we're going to do gameplay part 2 of The Cruel King and the Great Hero. We're at a good stopping point. And there's more tutorial that keeps popping up that I'm not actually reading. Let's see here. When she gets strong enough, she will be able to sprint in those places too. Also, when Yu runs, less monsters will appear. Take advantage of this when she's in a hurry. Okay. Slightly move, or while pressing B, Yu will be able to walk at her normal pace, but when Yu walks, more monsters will appear than normal. Okay. I did actually do a quick save. Let's see here, now that's the map. So if we do a regular. Then it does, yeah, the bookmark. Alright. Yep, we're gonna bookmark it now. Save complete. Close. Alright, guys. Well, I'm gonna be logging out. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you have any questions and stuff for the second video or later on, just let me know. And see you guys soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.